परमपिता बाबा की जय। नमस्कार टू ऑल। टुडे वी विल टॉक अबाउट फाउंडेशन ऑफ न्यू ह्यूमैनिस्टिक एजुकेशन एंड वी विल डिस्कस इट्स फिलॉसफी प्रिंसिपल प्रैक्टिस। दिस बुक इज रिटन बाय आनंद रमा दीदी एंड Eric Breen. So, from Talks on Education by Sri Prabhat Ranjan Sarkar, who says education is that which liberates. Real meaning of education is trilateral development, simultaneous development in a physical, mental and spiritual realms of human existence. This development should enhance the integration of human personality. By this, dormant human potentialities will be awakened and put to proper use. Educated are those who have learnt much, remembered much, and made use of their learning in practical life. Emphasis should be given to moral education and the inculcation of idealism, not only philosophy and tradition. The practice of morality should be the most important subject in the syllabus at all levels. Universalism should also be awakened in the child. Etiquette and refined behavior are not enough. Real education leads to a pervasive sense of love and compassion for all creation. The word education itself has special significance. E stands for enlargement of mind, D for dismap, in which D stands for discipline, E for etiquette, S for smartness, M for memory, E for English, and P for pronunciation. U stands for universal outlook, C for character, A for active habits, T for trustworthiness, I for ideation of great, O for omniscient grace, and N stands for nice temperament. Special importance should be attached to children's education because today's child is tomorrow's citizen. The receptive capacity of a child is great, but to enhance the receptivity, the method of education should be thoroughly psychological. From the beginning, children in India can be taught three languages: their mother tongue, or the appropriate classical language, and the world language. Students should be encouraged to learn the history of their respective mother tongues. By learning the world language, students will develop a feeling of world citizenship in their minds. Beside the mother tongue, student can also learn as many languages as possible. Let people know as many languages as they can. But in the practical field, government and non-government work and court work, the mother tongue should be used. During secondary education, vocational education should be introduced according to the natural tendency and spontaneous aptitude of the students. Talented student should be provided with special facilities if they are poor. After higher education, students with talent should get the opportunity to do research work with the financial aid of the government. The examination system should undergo a radical change so that the knowledge of student both in the applied and theoretical sides can be properly assessed. Students should be encouraged to involve themselves in social welfare and other constructive activities within their school or campus. After completing their education, students should be guaranteed appropriate employment. Proper care should be taken in the selection of teachers. Academic certificates are not the only criteria for selecting teachers. Qualities like a strong character, righteousness, social service, selflessness, an inspirational personality, and leadership ability should be evident in teachers. Teachers should get the highest respect in the society, and their economic need should be properly looked after. The framing of educational policies, the control of educational system, and all other activities concerned with education should be managed by a board comprised of efficient teachers. This board should enjoy full freedom and authority to carry out its duties. Education must be free from all political interference. Education should be free at all levels. Grown-up students, that is, adults, may take part in the non-academic side of administration. The academic side should be controlled and managed by educationists with the help and cooperation of grown-up students. Just as grown-up children may help their parents a lot in managing family duties, the relation between students and the teacher should be sweet. Radio, television, films and other media must be free from exploitation and vested interest. Qualified professionals should utilize such media for the benefit of students to ensure high quality education. The teaching of science must always be encouraged. The study and application of science will assist in the spread of knowledge and help to ensure that the right to knowledge in every sphere of life, social, economic, psychic, and spiritual, is attained by all. Knowledge and science must be free like the light, the air, and the unhindered wealth of nature. They must serve all and supply the vital juice of life. So we have just come to an end from Talks on Education by Sri Prabhat Ranjan Sarkar. We will just going to just carry forward our work in our next video. Till then, bye bye, namaskar to all. Have a good day. Thank you.